when insurance adjusters for a potential defendant, someone who caused your harm, take recorded statements, they not only seek to take your recorded statement, the person who is harmed, but they also universally take the recorded statement of the person who harmed you, because that is their insured. That's the person who they insure. The reason why they're calling you to take your recorded statement is because they know that their insured may be responsible for the harm that was caused to you. Now, the thing that is ironic about the recorded statement process is, if an insurance adjuster gets your recorded statement and you later hire an attorney, you can get a copy of your recorded statement, but whatever that other person said in their recorded statement to their own insurance company is not going to be accessible by you. So essentially what happens is the insurance company can get a recorded statement from you, use that against you in litigation, but you and your lawyer will not be able to get the internal insurance company statement that was given by their policyholder. That is fundamentally unfair, but it's a reality of the system we live in. They're not required to turn that over to me as a lawyer if I represent you in an injury case. So keep that in mind. When you are being asked to give a recorded statement to an insurance adjuster, ask that insurance adjuster, will you give me a copy of your policyholder's recorded statement so I can see what they're saying? And they'll probably chuckle at you and tell you no, but they're not gonna give that up. So again, it's just one of those points in the system that you need to think about when you're thinking about giving a recorded statement. It seems to be unfair, and it is unfair, but it's a reality that you're gonna have to deal with if you later have to hire a lawyer and proceed with legal action because they're lowballing you or denying your claim.
Been through hell? Call Heavens 24/7, 304-787-7777.